Good morning, students. Myself, Chandra Mohan, Assistant Professor, St. Martin's Engineering College. So today's my topic is Ordinary Differential Equations. Ordinary Differential Equations. First, so what is a differential equation? An equation involving the derivatives of one dependent variable with respect to two or more independent variables is called a differential equation. So for example, so d square y by dx square minus 3dy by dx plus 2y is equal to 0. Okay, so here y is a dependent variable and x is an independent variable. Okay, so now the definition of differential equation is an equation, so this is an equation which is involving the derivatives of one dependent variable with respect to one or more independent variables is called a differential equation. So this is an example for differential equation. Okay, so now there are two types of differential equation. First one is ordinary differential equation, and second one is partial differential equation. Partial differential equation. So there are two types of differential equation. First one is ordinary differential equation and second one is partial differential equation. Now coming to the definition of the ordinary differential equation. Okay, so now an equation involving the derivatives of one dependent variable with single independent variable is called a ordinary differential equation. So for example, you can take this example. So here this equation having only one independent variable and one single independent variable. So this is an example for ordinary differential equation. Okay, so once again, an equation which involves one dependent variable with respect to single independent variable is called a ordinary differential equation. Now coming to the partial differential equation. Okay, so the definition is an equation which involves one dependent variable with respect to two or more independent variables is called a partial differential equation. So for example, dou square u by dou x square plus dou square u by dou y square is equal to 0. Okay, so this is an equation which involves one dependent variable, that is u, and there are two independent variables x comma y. Okay, so this is called partial differential equation. So and it is also called Laplace equation. Okay, so now if the equation having single independent variable, then that equation is called ordinary differential equation. And if the equation having two or more independent variables, then that equation is called partial differential equation. Now in this chapter, we are going to learn so how to solve the ordinary differential equations. Okay, so now before that, so we have to learn about order and degree. Okay, so now what is order? Order of the differential equation. Okay, so an equation is said to be of order n if the nth derivative is the highest derivative in that differential equation. So for example, if you take this example, so d square y by dx square plus 2y dy by dx minus y is equal to 0. Okay, so here, so what is the highest derivative in this differential equation? Nth derivative. So what is the highest derivative? So second derivative is the highest derivative in the differential equation. Okay, so if the nth derivative is the highest derivative in the differential equation, so order is equal to n. So for this example, here second derivative is the highest derivative. So order of this differential equation is 2. Order is equal to 2. Understood? Okay. Now coming to the degree of. Okay. So what is degree? Degree of the differential equation. Okay. So the power of the highest order. So after removing fractions and its radicals. Okay. So that is called the degree of the given differential equation. Now the power of the highest derivative. Take the same example. Okay, so here what is the power of the highest derivative? Second derivative is the highest derivative, right? So the power of the highest derivative is 1. So degree is equal to 1. Okay, so the power of the highest derivative, it has been made. So the differential equation, after removing the radicals and fractions, then the power of the highest derivative gives us the degree of the given differential equation. Okay, so for example, so dy by dx is equal to d square y by dx square equal root over 1 plus dy by dx whole square. Okay, so here there is a fraction. Okay, 1 plus dy by dx whole to the power 1 by 2. Root means 1 plus dy by dx whole square whole to the power 1 by 2. So we have to remove this root. Okay, so that's why squaring on both sides. Squaring on both sides. So then you will get d square y by dx square is equal to 1 plus dy by dx whole square. Squaring on both sides. Okay, so which implies, so d square y by dx square is equal to, so 1 plus minus 1 minus, sorry. So d square y by dx square whole square minus dy by dx whole square minus 1 is equal to 0. We are removing the root. Okay, so now here we got ordinary differential equation. Now the power of the highest derivative, that is 2. So degree of this differential equation is 2. So degree is equal to 2. Okay, so now the next definition is solution. Solution of a differential equation. So it is a relation between dependent and independent variables and not having their derivatives is called a solution of the differential equation. So for example, y is equal to a cos x plus b sin x. Y is equal to a cos x plus b sin x. So I am saying this is a relation between the dependent variables and the independent variables. Okay. So here x is a dependent variable and y is dependent variable and x is independent variable. Okay. So it is a relation between dependent and independent variables and not having their derivatives. So there is no dy by dx and d square y by dx and all these. Okay. So I am saying this is a solution of the differential equation d square y by dx square plus y is equal to 0. Okay, so this is a solution of this differential equation d square y by dx square plus y is equal to 0. So once we can check it once. So y is equal to a cos x plus b sin x. Okay, so differentiating, ordinary differentiate with respect to x. So we get dy by dx. So dy by dx is equal to cos x derivative minus sin x. So minus a sin x and sin x derivative cos x. So plus b cos x. Okay. So we got dy by first derivative with respect to x. So differentiate it again. So we get a second derivative, that is d square y by dx square. So that is equal to sin x derivative cos x. So minus a cos x and cos x derivative minus sin x. So minus b sin x. Okay. Now put these in the given differential equation. Okay. So then we will get minus a cos x minus b sin x and plus y. What is y? So a cos x plus b sin x. So put it in this. A cos x plus b sin x. Okay, so let us see. So minus a cos x plus a cos x and minus b sin x plus b sin x. We are getting here 0. Okay, so finally, so what is the solution of the differential equation? So it is a relation between dependent and independent variables and not having their derivatives, and it should satisfy the given differential equation. Clearly it is satisfied. Okay, so y is equal to a cos x plus b sin x. So it is satisfying this differential equation. So we can say that y is equal to a cos x plus b sin x is a solution of the differential equation. Okay. So now coming to the general solution. So next to definition is general solution of a differential equation. Okay. So in the solution, number of arbitrary constants. So here how many arbitrary constants are there? Two. So that is a comma b. So there are two arbitrary constants. So that should be equal to the order of the differential equation. Okay. So here what is the order of this differential equation? Two. So you can take this example for general solution. Okay. So here there are two arbitrary constants. So number of arbitrary constants is equal to two. And the order of the differential equation, that is also two. So if number of arbitrary constants is equal to the order of the differential equation, then that solution is called general solution. Okay. So here we can say that y is equal to a cos x plus b sin x is a general solution of this differential equation. Clear? So now coming to the next definition, particular solution. So particular solution we can obtain by giving some particular values to the arbitrary constants. Okay, so by giving some particular values to the arbitrary constant, we can get the particular solution. So for example, so take the same example. Okay, so if you give some values to the arbitrary constant, I'm giving here a is equal to 1, some b is equal to minus 1. Okay, so then the solution becomes cos x minus sin x. Okay, so here we can say that y is equal to cos x minus sin x is the particular solution of the this differential equation d square y by dx square plus y is equal to 0. Clear? So by giving some particular values to the arbitrary constant, so we can get the particular solution. Okay, so now coming to the singular solution. So we cannot obtain singular solution from any particular solutions or from any general solution. So that type of solution is called singular solution. So we cannot obtain. So here, how can you obtain particular solution? So by giving some particular values to the arbitrary constants in the general solution. Okay, so then we can obtain particular solution. But here in case of singular solution, so we cannot obtain singular solution from any particular solution or from any general solution. Okay, so now coming to the next one. So in this chapter, we are going to learn how to solve the first order and first degree differential equations. Okay. So now let us see. So what is first order and first degree differential equation? Okay. So you can see dy by dx is equal to f of x comma y. So this is first order and first degree differential equation. Why? Because so here the highest derivative, this is a differential equation, right? So here what is highest derivative? So first derivative is the highest derivative. So the order is 1. Okay. So order is equal to 1. Order is equal to 1. And degree. So degree is equal to also 1. So this is a first order and first degree differential equation. Okay. So in this chapter we are going to learn how to solve the first order and first degree differential equations. Okay. So now there are some types of first order and first degree differential equations. So first one is variable separable type, and second one is homogeneous and non-homogeneous, and third one is exact and not exact, and fourth one is linear differential equation, and fifth one is Bernoulli's equation Bernoulli's equation. Okay, there are some types of first order and first degree differential equation. These are all first order and first degree differential. In next class, so we can learn all these types. Okay, thank you.